Right, I'm Alex Veneman of the Armstrong Group here at the University of Arizona, and today we're going to talk about how to perform conducting tip atomic force microscopy experiments. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to prepare our sample. Our sample in this case is indium tin oxide, which is a conducting transparent metal oxide. And we're going to start off by painting silver paste onto the backside to make contact with our instrument. Just a little strip on the top. Make sure it goes over the sides and onto the bottom. Oops. Then leave that there to dry and cover. Next, we're going to prepare and mount our cantilever onto our mount for the instrument. So since these particular chips come with three individual cantilevers and we're doing electrical measurements, we must knock off two of the excess tips. All right, so we'll go in and we'll pick a chip and bring in our tweezers and use them to knock off two of the excess tips, leaving just one on the chip. So first off, we'll check to make sure that there's no dust or any particulates sitting on the surface of our mount. And then we will gently pick up the cantilever chip and place it on the mount. Make sure that the chip is centered in the mount. And we're done. So while the silver paint on my sample is drying, I will install the conducting tip module and prepare the instrument to take measurements. So I start off by grounding myself because I'm going to be dealing with sensitive electronics, and we don't want to damage them. This is the conducting tip module, which I plug into the appropriate port on the instrument, and then I calibrate. I perform the calibration by plugging in a precision wire wound resistor. Adjust the amplifier offset in the module using the screwdriver, make a small change, and observe the change on the screen until my amplifier is zeroed out. We start by setting the microscope mode into the tuna mode, which is the tunneling AFM mode. And then to calibrate our amplifier, we will use the oscilloscope mode, which allows us to directly view the signal from our amplifiers. We'll turn on channel 2 as the tuna current and select the appropriate current sensitivity range. For our experiments, we usually use the 1 nanoamp per volt range. This is the current signal coming from the conducting tip module, and since we have no bias applied across the resistor, this current should be zero. So we'll adjust the current offset in the amplifier using a screwdriver and the potentiometer in there. Now the current reads zero, and the zero offset is correct. So we'll now set the slope of the amplifier by applying a test bias across the resistor. So we're applying 4 volts across our 1 gigaohm resistor, which should give us a current of 4 nanoamps. So we're slightly under that, and we will adjust the slope of the amplifier's response using our screwdriver again. So now it reads 4 nanoamps, so we can turn our bias off. It goes back to zero current, so we know that our amplifier is correctly zeroed and has the appropriate response. So now that we have zeroed out the conducting tip module, I can remove my calibration resistor and mount the module to the side of the scan head. Now that the conducting tip module is mounted on the scan head, we can mount the cantilever mount on the scan head. So we tighten this thumb screw to release the scanner head. Gently flip it upside down, being careful not to put a thumbprint on the laser window. The cantilever mount is seated on the four pins on the very top of the piezo scan head. And you must be very careful not to bend these, so very gently push the cantilever mount straight down. Make the electrical attachment to the amplifier using a pair of tweezers and being very gentle. The scan head can then be placed back in its dovetail and the thumb screw released to lock it into place. Now that the tip is mounted in the system, we can align the laser beam with the backside of the tip, and we'll do that by using these knobs to move the laser across the cantilever and observing the reflection of the laser in this window. We can tell when our laser beam is on the back of the cantilever because moving it side to side, our reflection will disappear very quickly. But moving it front to back, we can move along the cantilever fairly well. We'll now adjust the reflection of the cantilever, or the reflection of the laser beam off the back of the cantilever, so that it lines up with the detector. And we do that by adjusting these knobs on the left and observing the change in the signal from the detector on our screen.